India has perhaps one of the richest rock art treasures in the entire world, and that shows how great Indian civilization is and how old Indian civilization is. The oldest rock art which is available in India is roughly around 15,000 years back, which is proof that the Indian civilization is the oldest civilization. And it also tells about the lifestyles, the civilization, the style of living, the style of culture, the style of habitat which Indian people had 15,000 years back. So rock art studies has immense importance when we study about heritage, our lineage. And the importance of rock art studies has been very rightly realized by the Indira Gandhi National Center for the Arts when it started a project, a separate project on rock arts known as Adi Drishya Department.
The ibex is being a part of their ritual tradition. They worship him during the new year of Ladakh, which they locally called as Losar. And they make the images of ibex out of dough and bake it and worship it on that day. Similarly, we find that organs, male organ, of ibex, and also the conceived part image of ibex in the rock art tradition, which they connected with their fertility cult. We have continuity of tradition in the form of money stones also, that since from the prehistory we have its own history of the petroglyphs, which took the form of the linear shape in earlier stages in the rock art, and slowly it took the bas relief in the form of the images, giving the frontal part of it as a developmental phase. And similarly, in the later stage, we have full-scope sculptures or three-dimensional images. So in the Ladakh region, that all the three phases are being represented. Rock art is not an isolated art which has no context. It is within the context which is intrinsic to their mythology, religious beliefs and lifestyle.
Thank you. इसको हजारीबाग से 40 किलोमीटर दक्षिण में है और यहाँ पर हम लोग देखते हैं कि गुफा में बहुत सुंदर नियोचालकोलिथिक रॉक पेंटिंग्स हैं। जो रॉक पेंटिंग्स में जो हम लोग डिजाइंस पाए हैं वो डिजाइंस हम लोग यहाँ इसको गांव का मुंडा घर में पाते हैं। तो ऐसे ही हम लोग एक चलते चलते घर उठा लिए, खास हम लोग ढूंढे नहीं कोई घर को कि दोनों का डिजाइन मिलती है नहीं मिलती, तो भी आते के साथ में बसेरा के डिजाइन मिल गया के दोनों। उसका बाद में हम लोग ये ट्राइंगल डिजाइन जो देख रहे हैं जो इसको में मिलती, यहाँ आते तो देखते कि वो भी डिजाइन यहाँ, पनपत्ता के डिजाइन जो इसको में अभी हम लोग को मिल रहा है तो देख रहे वो भी यहाँ आ गया। ये जिगजैग डिजाइन जो देख रहे हैं ये इसको में भी हम लोग को रॉकट में मिलती। तो इससे हम लोग को अभी तुरंत आते के साथ पता होता है कि ये घर जो रॉक पेंटिंग से लगभग समझे 500 गज दूर है, इसका जो डेकोरेशन जो है उस रॉक पेंटिंग से जुड़ी हुई।
This is the Umatumoni Island in Shonitpur district of Assam. So here we have altogether three sites. We have the famous Sukreswar site, then we have the Bagreswari site, and also we have the Pani Bishwanath, which is situated in the heart of the river Brahmaputra. So this site we have found different petroglyphic signs of chessboard, holes, loops, human figures and other designs, also designs of a temple and houses. We have been trying to document this, and we have also tried to have a multidisciplinary study of the whole landscape of this Umatumoni Island and adjoining areas of Bishwanath Ghat, which is historically, anthropologically and environmentally also a very important site in Assam.
Thank you. colors which are used insofar as the paintings are concerned. There may be paintings in red color, in ochre color, in chocolate brown, in white, in green, so on and so forth. These are the basically the paintings are in these colors. And the prehistoric man or whosoever made these paintings used basically the mineral colors or the vegetable colors. Now, for example, in several sites you come across this hematite. Hematite was used for doing paintings in red color. And for white, some kind of the calcium carbonates were used. Now, naturally, for preparing these pigments, for making these colors, for doing the paintings, the artists, the prehistoric artists, or the artists who prepared them in the historical times, must have mixed these colors with some kind of a glue. It may have been, or resins. And for making these paintings, brushes were used. They might have used the quills, the porcupine's quills, or you know, just using their fingers itself for making these lines, drawing these lines.
Thank you. Pandavalagattu, or in other words, the cave of Pandavas. Here you find the frescoes of the medieval times, possibly datable to 13th to 14th centuries, in which, according to him, is the story of Mahabharata, in which, as his explanation goes, there are scenes which depict the Pandavas going in exile, and it also depicts some story about Ghatotkaja, Duryodhana, and some scenes in which the Pandavas are supposed to have been burnt in a cave is Lankagriha, as it is described in Mahabharata. So all these scenes are ascribed to the Mahabharata. They describe this cave as the cave of the Pandavas, because it is in the shape of the hood of the snake, and the scene is also depicted here, according to him, is the Adiseshu of the bed of the Vishnu. That is the story as described by Sri Narayana, the priest of this cave.
As far as Tamil Nadu is concerned, the earliest rock art is associated with the Neolithic site. So we are having two type of rock shelters, one on the rock shelter, another on the Iron Age megalithic monuments, popularly called megalithic monuments, but actually it is Iron Age graves, mostly at the foothills. But most of the Iron Age graves are dolmens, but we do have cist burial, dolmen, anthropomorphic and other urn burials. But only the dolmen is having the arch inside the chamber. And while making this painting, they preferred the western slab, particularly the slab opposite to the portico first when they prefer. And when it is get or we can say completely it is covered, then they have preferred other orthostrats. And in some sites, they have paintings below the capstone also. So that way we are having a two association, one is with the rock shelter, one is with the Iron Age graves. But in the case of Neolithic sites, and we are having only painting on the shelters. And the site which is associated with the Neolithic habitation is normally having a red pigment and superimposed with the white pigment. So it clearly shows that the red pigment is earlier than the white pigment. But all the Iron Age graves or the rock shelter associated with the Iron Age sites are having only white pigment. We hardly get red pigments, which shows that there are two cultural phases that are associated with the rock art. One is red pigment, which is associated with the Neolithic times, and the white, which is later in times, may be associated with the Iron Age sites.
In this film, the Indira Gandhi National Center for the Arts has tried to give you an idea about the rich heritage our country has about the rock arts. We know there are more and more rock shelters, rock arts available in different parts of the country. The process is still on. The list is endless. The creations are countless, but the efforts are going on. We need your wholehearted support for this endeavor. Unless there is a social awareness, unless there is a zeal, unless there is a desire to preserve these rock arts, things will not move. And if we don't preserve them today, tomorrow we are going to repent. So let us come together and make study of rock art as a movement for study, as a movement of research, as a movement of documentation. Let's come together and celebrate India's rich cultural heritage through the depiction of rock arts.